You're watching Tag.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. The festival of Christmas lights up gloomy winter days. Lavish feasts, scrumptious desserts, melodious carols and colourful Christmas trees make us rejoice the birth of Jesus Christ. The festival was celebrated recently with full fervor all across the country to deliver the message of sacrifice and hope and mark the birth of a Messiah.
1,000 church bells rang together in unison as the clock struck 12 at midnight. Devotees from all across the country gathered in churches to celebrate the birth of Lord Jesus. Senior bishops and priests conducted sacred rituals and ceremonies and gave out the message of unconditional love for all.
Christmas is a beautiful time when we come together and rejoice that Jesus is born among us. And Jesus brings to us the message of peace. Peace from God, peace with one another. We love one another as human beings. Jesus came and was born as a human being, not belonging to any group or any caste, but he was a human being first of all. And that is the beautiful message that we have.
Churches were dolled up with lights and candles. Miniatures of Jesus, Mother Mary and Father Joseph were kept inside a stable to portray the birth of Jesus Christ. Devotees followed rituals like exchanging gifts, decorating Christmas trees, attending church, sharing meals with family and friends as they waited for Santa Claus to arrive. People were also seen paying homage to Lord Jesus by offering their prayers to him and touching his feet and singing midnight masses.
For me, Christmas is one of the most important day of the, in the year, complete year. So it's all about spending time with family, friends, being a better person. This is how I see Christmas as.
Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem in around 6 BC and sacrificed his life for greater good of the people. Christmas is celebrated all over the world on 25th December to mark his birth anniversary.
Moving on. As the whole country indulged in joyful festivities of Christmas, the Christ Church in Indian hill town of Shimla in Himachal Pradesh has been setting a tone of peaceful and harmonious coexistence among different religious communities of India. The church invited people from across the faiths to participate in mass prayers performed during Christmas Day and celebrate diversified cultures of the nation. Have a look. India is the largest multicultural and one of the most diversified countries around the world. In every 200 kilometers, there are people of a different dialect, caste, creed and religion. Since years, Indians have been celebrating a number of festivals together, whether it is Eid, Diwali, Holi or Guru Parb. A similar scene was witnessed in the Christ Church of Shimla, where people of different traditions and beliefs collectively celebrated Christmas and offered their prayers to Lord Jesus, giving the message of oneness and harmony.
I'm actually Sikh, so I'm part of that multicultural
finding that I feel a lot of peace and joy in my heart tonight, and that's what I'm bringing with me home.
Setting a perfect example of communal harmony, devotees of various religions gathered inside the church to listen to the preachings of the priest and celebrate the spirit of Christmas. Devotees and visitors paid their homage to Jesus Christ, who had sacrificed his life for greater good and gave the message of hope and morality.
परमेश्वर हर मनुष्य से प्रेम करता, वो किसी धर्म विशेष के व्यक्ति से नहीं करता, और परमेश्वर हर एक मनुष्य को जीवन देना चाहता है और बहुत याद का जीवन देना चाहता है, और इसलिए आज जो क्रिसमस है वो सभी धर्म के लोगों ने मिलकर यहाँ हमारे साथ प्रार्थना सभा में सहभागी हुए और हमने सबों के लिए प्रार्थना की.
Over the years, these different traditions, rituals and festivals have become the binding force between different religions practiced in the Indian society. Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Tourists and locals in India's northern hill state of Himachal Pradesh enjoyed a ride in country's first narrow gauge train with translucent ceiling. The train, which has 7 coaches, was decked up for the first ride from northern Kalka railway station to its final destination of Shimla town.
The way they have made it, they have made the arrangement for AC and all that, and the top dome is transparent, and you can have the view of the sky also, and the windows are very good, I would say. The seating arrangement is good.
The tourists said they were elated with the experience of the journey, where they could enjoy the views from the windows, and the see-through ceilings called the vista domes provided the view of the skies.
It was fantastic. I've never been on anything like this before, especially with the views. They're so gorgeous. It was also very comfortable, a comfortable train, even though small.
Famed for its panoramic views as it climbs more than 4,000 feet through heritage tunnels, along multi-arched bridges, the narrow gauge 96-kilometer Kalka to Shimla route is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Hundreds of space enthusiasts and students gathered in different parts of India to watch the annular solar eclipse, also known as a ring of fire, on Thursday. The last solar eclipse of the decade, an annular one, was seen in totality or partially by people from the northern Mariana Islands, Guam, India, Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, Singapore, Sri Lanka, and the United Arab Emirates.
The moon is actually coming in between the sun and earth, and that is how we sense, I mean, the eclipses. So we were in fact between earth, moon, we were between earth. So this eclipse which we viewed was from a bit, we went in fact in a space, I mean, at a height altitude about 21,000 feet. And that is where we could sense that, yes, so we are somewhere between earth and moon.
The annular eclipse started from Dammam in Saudi Arabia and travelled across the Indian Ocean towards southern India and over the northern part of Sri Lanka and ended above the Pacific Ocean. In India's western Mumbai, Ahmedabad cities and southern Chennai city, people were seen using solar viewers, filters and telescopes as they viewed the solar phenomenon that started around 8 a.m. and continued till around 11:30 a.m. Indian Standard Time.
I just know beautifully arranged by the Scientific Institute in Ahmedabad, and they are giving out these globes through which you can see the solar eclipse.
Meanwhile, devotees were seen taking holy dips, praying to the sun god in holy river Ganges in northern Varanasi city. According to Hindu religious beliefs, taking a bathe in a water body on the day of solar eclipse adds to one's good karma and washes off ill effects of the eclipse.
Moving on, Japan, with its latest technological advancements, is certainly revolutionizing the world around. Along with its technology, the country's food culture is also garnering praise across the globe. Ise Foods, a giant in Japanese food market, is outreaching to the countries in Asia to give them a taste of Japanese food culture. As New Year is round the corner, Japan is all set to celebrate its success in global market and revive its lucky charm for the year to come. Take a look.
Mori no Tamago is a popular long-selling egg of Ise Foods, the pioneer egg company in Japan. In Japanese food culture, people eat raw egg. Ise Foods have technology to keep egg fresh and tasty. Mori no Tamago is now available in Thailand also. Supermarket Don Quixote is popular among Japanese living in Bangkok. Various kinds of Japanese food are sold in this store. Mori no Tamago are lined up in a special refrigerator. Thai people don't have the habit of eating raw eggs, but the shop recommends everyone to eat this raw egg. Ise Foods brought egg freshness keeping technology to Thailand to produce fresh egg.
この卵だったら卵かけご飯とかもシンプルにいただけますし、あとはもう目玉焼きとかもあのタイのやつだと結構固めに焼かなきゃいけないんですけど、あの半熟系でいただこうかなと。
In Bangkok, Japanese restaurants are increasing due to the Japanese food boom. Teppan is quite popular among business people. Many kinds of rice bowl are served with egg yolk. The combination of sashimi and egg yolk is good visually and makes harmony of taste.
生卵を乗せた丼がもうタイの人にもうすごい受けたっていうか、そこで思いっきり広がってですね、てっぺんの主力商品のメインになりました。森の卵を他のメニューにもどんどん採用して、ほとんど 30% ぐらいのてっぺんの主力商品は全部森の卵で作らせていただいて、そこから味がすごい変わって、卵料理であったりてっぺんのファンが思いっきり増えてきましたね。
You and I is Japanese style hot pot restaurant with buffet style. Eggs on the shelves are Mori no Tamago. Thai people call it Mori Tama. Visitors can eat meat and vegetable with mixed raw egg.
ตอนนี้ผมการตอบรับจากลูกค้าค่อนข้างดีนะคะในภาพรวมปัจจุบันจากลูกค้าค่ะค่อนข้างเห็นได้ชัดทางนี้ตั้งแต่ทางร้านนะคะได้นำไข่มอริธรรมะนะคะมาเป็นจุดขายด้วยสไตล์การทานแบบดั้งเดิมคือทานแบบจุ่มเนื้อกับไข่ดิบนะคะเพิ่มความหอมหวานยังมีความปลอดภัยมาตรฐานญี่ปุ่นอีกด้วยนะคะซึ่งพอรวมกับส่วนผสมที่เข้ากันเนื้อและน้ำซุปที่เป็นจุดเด่นของร้านยิ่งทำให้ลูกค้าตอบรับอย่างดีค่ะโดยยังให้ทางเลือกกับลูกค้าโดยทางร้านเรามีทั้งทานในร้านและให้ลูกค้าซื้อกลับบ้านด้วยค่ะ
As a pioneer in Japanese egg industry, raw egg of Ise Food is bringing new food culture in Thailand. Asakusa Sensoji, Tokyo's oldest temple, is a very popular tourism spot in Japan. At the end of year, Hagoita Ichi Festival is held to sell good luck charms Hagoita, which is ornamental bat based on those used in the traditional New Year's game of Hanatsuki, a bit like badminton.
これは Hagoita と言いまして、縁起物なんですよ。で、日本で言うと、上が水広がり広がってますよね。で、昔はここで羽をつきましてと邪気を悪魔を跳ねのける、そういう意味があって、お子様の健康を あれして飾るんですよ。で、昔は正月だけ飾ったんですけども、今は一年中飾るような感じになってます。
The motif of Hagoita is an actor in Japanese entertainment traditional show Kabuki. Decoration is made by skill of traditional craft art.
もともとですね、あのボール紙ですね、ボール紙に中に綿を入れて切れでくるむというのが教えという技法です。それが、何十かのパーツがありまして、それを組み合わせて立体的にするのが教えという技法になっています。
These Hagoita are unique. The motifs represent Rugby World Cup held in Japan, Tokyo 2020 Olympics and movie characters. This action is Tejim. Its meaning is wishing a good time next year.
เหมือนงานศิลปะที่ถ่ายทอดความเป็นญี่ปุ่นแล้วก็มีความสีสันที่สวยงามค
่
ะ
Asakusa Tourism Area in Tokyo is filled with traditional lucky decorations until the beginning of the new year. Foreign tourists can spend valuable and happy time here.
Moving on, a hallmark of India is its diversity. People from different religious and cultural backgrounds live here amicably. It is this unity that brings people from different communities to share their joy and grief among themselves. Upholding this tradition of unity in diversity, a group of doctors and social workers from diverse religious backgrounds are providing free eye treatment services to the public in Bareilly town of Uttar Pradesh. Take a look.
The northern Indian city of Bareilly in Uttar Pradesh is known across India for its diversified cultures and unity among different religious communities. The diversity in the city has given its residents an ample opportunity to learn and imbue different cultures and help them grow in a peaceful and a unified society. Taking inspiration from this humanitarian culture, a group of doctors and social workers in Bareilly has been providing eye treatment services to the public without charging any fee from their patients.
मैं समझता हूँ लगभग 20 से 22 हजार अभी तक मोतियाबिंद के निशुल्क ऑपरेशन किए जा चुके हैं। बीच में हम मरीजों को लेकर दिल्ली भी जाया करते थे, वहाँ ऑपरेशन करा के लाया करते थे, और ऊपर वाले की कृपा है, अब तक कोई भी ऑपरेशन में दिक्कत नहीं आई किसी मरीज को। मेरा मैं तो इतने सालों से हूँ, मैं देख रहा हूँ कि कैंप में किसी भी धर्म संप्रदाय का व्यक्ति आया, उसके कोई भेदभाव नहीं होता है। जिसको ऑपरेशन की आवश्यकता है उसका ऑपरेशन किया जाता है, और मेरा मानना तो ये है सामाजिक कार्य में इन सब चीज़ों का कोई महत्व नहीं होता है। किसी भी धर्म का व्यक्ति हो, अगर सामाजिक कार्य मन से कर रहे हैं आप, तो सबके लिए होना चाहिए।
Established in 2001 by Virendra Verma, the NGO has held several health camps across the city and outside to provide free eye checkup and health services to the people coming from different communities.
वहाँ पे किसी को ये देख के नहीं लिया जाता है कि ये हिंदू है या मुस्लिम है या कौन है। वहाँ पे जो भी मरीज आता है वो मरीज होता है, और वहाँ पे सेवा करने वाले भी ये नहीं है कि केवल हिंदू ही है या मुसलमान ही है। वहाँ पे हिंदू मुसलमान सभी लोग आकर के उसमें सेवा करते हैं और सारे मरीजों की सेवा करते हैं।
Apart from free checkup and treatment, the patients are also provided with free snacks and tea every evening.
मैं भारत सेवा ट्रस्ट से 8-10 साल से जुड़ा हुआ हूँ, और हर शाम को रोज यहाँ पर मरीजों की आके सेवा करते हैं, उनको नाश्ता कराते हैं, यहाँ मैं खुद देखता हूँ कि यहाँ पर 40-50% मुस्लिम लोग आते हैं जिनका ऑपरेशन निःशुल्क किया जाता है.
This noble work started by the Bharat Seva Trust is being supported by many humanitarians in the city. Whether one is Hindu or a Muslim, a number of people have joined the noble cause to serve the weaker section of the society in many different ways. Such an example of selfless service towards the public at large certainly highlights the inherent nature of the humans in India who keep humanity above any religion or classification.
Moving on to science and technology, the world looks at India as a technology giant as the country is taking huge strides in the field of artificial intelligence and innovations. So, in today's episode, let's meet Roshan, a young college dropout turned innovator from Manipur who has created a humanoid robot all by himself.
Terminator, RoboCop, Wall-E, R2-D2, C-3PO. These iconic robot characters from films have fascinated one and all and made us wish that we had one of our own. Fascinated by all these robotic characters, a young college dropout from Manipur has designed a humanoid called Important Voice Authentication Live Assistant, Iwala, for his personal assistance. Iwala can be controlled via smartphone and it can pick up objects from a 100 meter distance and can reply to questions and communicate in English.
Right now in Imphal, 68 and sunny. Today, it'll be mostly sunny.
21-year-old Roshan Mitai is a first-year student of Industrial Training Institute in Manipur. Although Roshan could not complete his graduation in biochemistry from Oriental College in Imphal due to financial constraints, he enrolled in ITI and started working on building a humanoid robot in February last year.
I ID Hamada, I know Adunganas Hava from the ID Sumna Karama, ID remote control, ID Makala, some quota with Doctor Angan, some China, Vishag, and a Toro Maneva. I did Shani Sari, and a Kurt or Winners Hara again as Hara, Aduga, Sarakanida, ID Merkta, Mamma Dinanga, ID, I know Mamma Vadas, where ID Port Lahoda, Wish Honing, but ID Masum Angang with Kanga Maneva. ID Aduko and everybody don't come by ID later, beginning with the whole Jesus. Ado, I know Marasum Sounding, but I do, well, Mamma Dinanga, Aduitazu, some who is sheep.
The components of the robot include mechanum wheels, web camera, Bluetooth, CPU disk, server motor, and it also has a teaser gun. Roshan said it has cost him more than 1 lakh rupees and spent 1.5 years to develop the robot. Roshan's initiative was appreciated by all, including Manipur Chief Minister N. Biren Singh.
I is a senator, Benina Tonga, the Benina, Maggie Budagina, Tragamaik, Pupu, I Ekora, the Gi, Moiti, Matin, the Sum Laure, my Chief Hana Bonabada. I eat Hangabada, Labour, I gi, Kakatombi, Kakatombi, support that way. That is minor, my Amna. A Nangin Hazard is mine, she's had a mean and hybrid. My amgi. I know my am sitting around spoon the tagger of my am dinner. Walk even my am say. She's a loin cow gray. Narangi no missida.
Roshan, who hails from a family of a carpenter, had no formal training or expertise in the field other than his observation-driven knowledge. He has set an example for the youth that passion and knowledge can lead to a lot of possibilities and make dreams come true.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
You're watching Tag.